Hey, welcome back to the Mr. Excel Netcast. I'm Bill Jones.
Basically, you start out with massive amounts of data. You say, how are we going to analyze this? Well, let's fire up a pivot table and see if we can solve this problem.
Hey, welcome back to the Mr. Excel Netcast. I'm Bill Jelen. Hey, let's take a look at Excel 2010's pivot table features. Now, back in episode 1067, I covered the new slicer feature, but there's some other cool things they've given us in pivot tables. So let's create a quick pivot table here. Click OK, and I'm going to put a couple of different fields down the left-hand side, and then revenue, cost of goods sold, and profit going across. And one frustration that we had in Excel 2007 was that it puts both region and product in column A, but there was always a way to solve that in Excel 2007. We came back here to report layout. We could say show in outline form, and then we get back to the normal view where we have region in column A and product in column B. But, you know, if you've been in one of my seminars or read any of my books, you know that for me, most of the time, a pivot table is a means to an end. I take this pivot table, I then want to go through and convert it to values, that way I can do other things with it. But when I convert it to values, it's very frustrating that they do not fill in these items here in column A. And in past podcasts, I've gone through and shown you how to use edit, go to, special, blanks, and then equal, up arrow, control, enter to fill all those in. But now, finally, they've given us an option so that way you don't have to go through that whole dance anymore. Back here on the Pivot Table Tools Design tab, go to Report Layout and say, repeat all item labels, and it fills in the word central all the way down. This is excellent. The very first book that I wrote back in 2002, the Guerrilla Data Analysis using Microsoft Excel, I complained bitterly about this, and I know one time when I was out at Microsoft, I saw that book on the table, and they had little sticky notes, and so, you know, back from 2002 here to 2009, it took 7 years, but that has finally been corrected. That is a huge, huge improvement in pivot tables, especially if you're taking this data and then want to do something else with it, you know, further analysis. So, great, simple little feature that they added in will make life much easier for those of us using pivot tables in order to get a data set that we can then do further analysis with. Hey, I want to thank you for stopping by. We'll see you next time for another Netcast from Mr. Excel.
Well, thanks for stopping by. We'll see you next time for another Netcast. Mr. Excel.